Hello and welcome to another video. I'm Jimmy, the head of support at Tifio, and in this quick guide, we will show you how to handle taxes for Shopify stores in the Netherlands. If you are running a Shopify store in the Netherlands, it is essential to know when to charge VAT and which tax rate applies to different customers. The first and most crucial step is to understand if your business is registered for VAT. If it's not, you shouldn't charge VAT on your sales, regardless of where your customers are located. You can learn more about this in our EU VAT tax guide, linked in the description below. In the Netherlands, there are three tax rates: the standard rate, the reduced rate, and the zero-rated tax rate. As of February 2024, the standard VAT rate is set at 21%, and it applies to most goods and services. Alongside this, there's a reduced VAT rate of 9%, meant for specific products like food, soft drinks, books, newspapers, basic antiques and transportation charges. If you'd like to delve deeper into these rates and their applications, we've provided a link to the official website of the tax administration where you can find more detailed information. When selling physical goods in the Netherlands within the EU, you will need to apply different tax rates depending on your taxable turnover for your business. Shopify simplifies this by automatically calculating tax rates based on your chosen registration type in the tax settings. There are three main registration types to consider: microbusiness, one-stop shop, and the country-specific registration type. Although we've provided comprehensive details for each of these registrations in our EU tax guide video, let's quickly take a look at each one of them. If your yearly revenue from sales to other EU countries is below 10,000 euros excluding VAT, you qualify for a microbusiness exemption, which means that when selling physical goods to customers in the Netherlands and the EU, you should charge your Dutch VAT rate. Larger stores often exceed this microbusiness threshold when selling cross-border, that is, across multiple EU countries. If this applies to your business and your store, you will need to apply VAT rates specific to those countries you're selling to, which in other words means based on your customer's shipping address. Alternatively, if you prefer for a more granular approach and choose to register for VAT in each EU country you are selling to, you need to include the local VAT registration number for every country where you hold registration to your Shopify tax settings. With this information in place, Shopify will then automatically apply VAT rates corresponding to your specific VAT registrations. There are special rules for selling digital goods from the Netherlands to other EU countries. But first, it is critical to understand what exactly digital services are. Even though your business uses the internet to facilitate sales, this does not always mean that you are providing e-services. For example, the sale of goods where the order and the processing are done electronically, such as through a Shopify store, it is not a supply of digital services. This is regarded as a sale of goods and follows the usual VAT rules we mentioned earlier. Digital goods, on the other hand, or services, therefore include radio and television broadcasting services, telecommunication services, or electronically supplied services such as online magazines, music, films, and games. If you are providing digital services from the Netherlands to customers in other EU countries, you will need to register for VAT regardless of your revenue. When selling to individuals or non-VAT registered businesses, you have two options. You will either submit the EU one-stop shop VAT return or register for VAT in the customer's country and apply their VAT rate. However, if you are selling digital services to VAT registered businesses, then they are responsible for any VAT due to the tax authorities in their country. Now that we've covered the different registration types and the corresponding VAT regulations, let's see how to set up your Shopify store for VAT collection in the Netherlands and the EU. To set VAT rates for selling physical goods, in your Shopify admin, go to the Settings, Taxes and Duties page. In the Regional Settings section, click on European Union. In the VAT on Sales window, click on Collect VAT, select your registration type and click Next. Select the country and enter your VAT number. If you have applied for a VAT registration number but don't have one yet, leave this field blank. You can update it later when you receive it. Save your changes by clicking on the Collect VAT button. If you're selling reduced rated or zero rated goods, you will need to set up tax overrides for these specific products in your Shopify store. Let's see how that works. To set up tax overrides, in your Shopify admin, go to the Settings, Taxes and Duties page. In the Regional Settings section, click on European Union. In the Tax Rates and Exemptions section, click Override, add a collection of products that are subject to the reduced or zero rate and set their tax rate respectively. Apply your settings using the Add Override button. If your business is VAT registered and you want to sell to both consumers and business customers in different countries of the EU, you may choose from two settings, depending on how you want to display product prices in your Shopify store. If you primarily sell to consumers, you may prefer to display product prices with VAT included, while still allow your business customers from other EU countries to have VAT deducted at checkout. Here's how you can achieve it. In your Shopify admin, go to the Settings, Taxes and Duties page. In the Decide how tax is charged section, check the Include tax in prices checkbox. Click Save to apply the changes. Now go to the Settings, Market Preferences page and switch the Include or Exclude tax based on your customer's country toggle on. If your customer base primarily consists of businesses, you may choose to display product prices excluding VAT. This, on the other hand, can be set up this way. In your Shopify admin, go to the Settings, Taxes and Duties page. In the Decide how tax is charged section, uncheck the Include tax in prices checkbox. Click Save to apply the changes. Now, go to the Settings, Market, Preferences page and make sure that the Include or Exclude tax based on your customer's country toggle is switched off. I hope this guide gave you the confidence to navigate Dutch taxes. To learn more, feel free to check our written guide on setting up Dutch taxes in your Shopify store, which is linked in the description below. If you have questions about any of the steps that we discussed, leave a comment and we will do our best to get back to you. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Jimmy and I wish you all the best on your e-commerce journey.